Good morning, children. This is Yogesh from Sri OP Jindal Vidyaniketan Samaguga. Dear children, so today we are having the poem The Boy in a Blue Pullover. And who has written this? The poet is Ruskin Bond. Ruskin Bond is specially known for the children's writing. He is famous among the children. So, let's get started. Here you can see the poem The Boy in a Blue Pullover. So, first I will recite this. Okay? Boy in a faded blue pullover. Poor boy, thin, smiling boy. So here in these two lines, you can say that actually the boy is being described. What he was wearing? Faded blue pullover. So what is pullover? As you can see on the right side, there are word meanings which you have to write in your copy. Putting today's date. What is pullover? A piece of clothing that is usually made of a warm material such as wool, has long sleeves and is worn over the top part of the body and is put on by pulling it over your head. You can see in the picture that is a blue pullover, but not only blue pullover, but it is a faded. That means less bright in color than before. So it was faded in the sense that means when it was bought, it was having the bright color. But after some time, its color faded. That become less bright. And even actually this faded pullover, it shows actually that the poverty of that child. Okay. So, boy in a faded blue pullover, poor boy, thin, smiling boy, ran down the road shouting, singing, flinging his arms wide. See, these two lines actually shows that the boy was so happy because he was running down the road. He was shouting, singing, okay? And flinging is what? To throw something or someone suddenly and with a lot of force. It shows actually his excitement. That means he was going to do something. And here I, who is this I? I stood in the way and stopped him. What's up? I said. Why are you happy? So here the narrative. And who is the narrator? The poet. Okay, so that stood by the way. And the narrator wanted to ask actually that what's the matter? What's up in the sense that means that is used as a friendly greeting to ask someone how they are or to ask what is happening, what happened. So the narrator wanted to ask. That means the narrator is what? The mouthpiece of the poet. The poet himself wants to ask. So what's the happening? What's happened? Why is he so happy? Okay. Then what that the boy did? He showed me the nickel rupee coin. I found it on the road, he said. Then the boy was wearing the faded blue pullover, he showed the narrator that nickel rupee coin. What is called nickel rupee? Nickel is what? It's a chemical element, or that is a silver white metal. So that means that rupee coin that was made of nickel. And that boy actually found that nickel rupee coin on the road. He told the narrator, the man who stood by the way. Okay. And he held it to the light that he might see it shining bright. See here, light, bright, it's rhyming. Okay. So he wanted to see the shining of that a rupee coin, nickel rupee coin. Okay. So he shown that to that man, to the narrator. Small boy in blue pullover. So he was so small, but got a rupee coin and he was so happy. Okay, so let's see what is there in the next stanza. Now here, the narrator already asked actually in the previous stanza that, and how will you spend it, small boy in a blue pullover? So narrator asked actually how he will spend that money, that rupee. So what was the reply of the boy? I will buy a buckle for my belt. What is buckle? You know very well actually. Okay. So you can see actually right side, the picture is there. That is called buckle. A piece of metal at one end of a belt or strap used to fasten the two ends together. So this is called buckle. So that boy wanted to buy a buckle for his belt. Slim boy, that means thin, smart boy, would buy a buckle for his belt. Coin clutched in his hot hand. He ran off laughing, bright. The coin I did lost an hour ago, but better is that night. So what do we understand actually from this stanza? We understand that actually the narrator, he lost that coin. Okay. But the boy got it. Okay, and he clutched that. What do you mean by clutched? To take or try to take hold of something tightly. He clutched it. That means he got it. That means that was his. And even the narrator was also happy. Why? Because the way he wanted to spend it, to buy a buckle. And even actually by the happiness of that boy, the narrator was so delighted. And even actually the narrator said that actually he was a smart boy. Because he wanted to spend that money not on useless things, but to buy a buckle for his belt. Which is, you can say, that is very necessary for him then. So as the narrator lost it an hour ago, but he also wanted that boy actually to spend it, because he was spending it for a good reason. So that's why he said that, but better is that night. So even actually he doesn't want it to claim it. Okay, he doesn't want it to shatter his happiness. He also became very happy to help that boy. Okay, so that's where very nice poem. There are many people actually who wanted to help the poor, the needy people. Okay, so like we are having some names like Mother Teresa, right? And even on this pandemic, so we have heard also name, one of the name actually, the Bollywood star, Sonu Sood, you know. So he helped many people actually to arrange, you know, from one place to another for their places, to their villages. Okay, he spent a lot of money. So the happiness actually which he saw on the faces of the people, that made actually people, this kind of people, happy. So even actually you can find out nearby your locality, they're the needy people, the poor people. So you can also help them, you know. So this poem is having a very beautiful message. So what do we learn from this poem? We learn that if you help somebody, okay, they become so happy. We can see the happiness in their faces. So they are just enjoying actually that 1 rupee coin. It's not a big amount. Okay, but for the poor and needy people, actually 1 rupee also counts. Some little help also count. Okay. So here actually the narrator, he was very kind. He was empathetic. Okay. So this is what actually shows about. So what is to be done actually for the poor and needy people. Right. So you must also do some this kind of, okay, actions to the poor and needy people. So let's see what is there in the next. Yes, let's enjoy the poem a little more. What do you think the words faded and thin say about the boy? So as I told you, actually he was wearing a faded blue pullover. Faded in the sense you can say like that worn out pullover also. Faded in the sense that means which lost its color. It become a less bright color. Okay, so these poor people, they used to wear the things like this. Okay, thin, it shows actually that they are not getting the meal or the stomach full meal, right? So it suggests that actually that boy was poor. It says that the boy was poor. How did the poet know the boy was happy? See, the boy was smiling, running, singing, shouting, flinging his arms wide. All these things suggest that actually that boy was so happy. Now the third one, what was the reason for the boy's happiness? What was the reason? Yes, he got 1 rupee coin. He had found a 1 rupee coin on the road. Right? So that's bring happiness. What was the small boy planning to buy? So, buckle. He wanted to buy a buckle for his belt. Do you think the poet approved of the boy's plan? Say why? Yes, definitely. The poet, or you can say the narrator of this poem, approved the boy's plan. How we can see? Because he calls the boy smart. Okay. Now, the poem ends with a surprise. What is the surprise? Obviously, the man, the poet, he lost that coin. Okay. The coin belonged to the man, but he didn't claim because he doesn't want to shatter his happiness. He doesn't want the boy to be sad. Okay, so that surprises us. Okay, did the poet think the boy deserved the coin? Say why? Yes, he deserved it. Because that it was not a big amount, but that was the small amount, and that made that boy so happy. And the happiness in that just 1 rupee coin, because he was so poor. So that's why the poet thought that actually he deserved. He would serve him, and that 1 rupee coin would serve him well. Now, 8th, read out the lines that rhyme. So here are some very 2, 3, 4 lines are there. As I told you, that light and bright, and he held it to the light that he might see it shining bright. So these are the two words, light and bright, which are rhyming. Okay. Right. So very less. Okay. Now, mostly the lines in the poem don't rhyme. Why do you think this is so? What we can say? Because this poem conveys a beautiful message of helping the needy people, or instead of just enjoying the rhyme, actually the message it conveys, it's having the importance of and the main theme of the poem. And even you can say that actually it is a stylistic choice of the poet, you know, right? So might be this is also. So here, this word meanings you have to write, and this question answers also, which we already discussed. And now you can see actually right side, here are the answer key, the boy in a blue pullover. So let's enjoy the poem a little more, page 101. So you go through all these things, write down the question and write down the answers. You can take a screenshot of this video, of this slide, and then you can use it whenever you want, you know, instead of just playing again and again actually this video. So it's better actually take a screenshot, and you can write down the questions and answers in your copy. And please don't forget actually that you have to write the word meanings also. Okay, so happy and have a nice day, and please be safe. Okay, thank you and goodbye.